Are you a newbie genealogist who wants to use the free website FamilySearch.org and you're just a little bit confused? Well, in today's video, we're going to cover some of the basics of using FamilySearch. Howdy! I'm Devin Noel-Lee with Family History Fanatics, where we help you understand DNA, climb your family tree, and write your ancestors' stories along the way. We do this through videos like these on YouTube, through virtual conferences we coordinate, as well as books available on Amazon. Check out the links in the description. In the video that Caleb made talking about using the timeline feature on FamilySearch, Penelope Main had a question in the comments section. She said, how do you get from the login to the timeline? And actually, how do you use FamilySearch? Well, we're going to talk about that in more details. But first, I have to tell you about an old video that we released. It was by Andy Lee, and he talked to you about how to connect yourself to your first deceased relative, and then you're going to see your family tree. Check out that video, and again, the link is in the description. So let's go to FamilySearch and take a tour to help newbies like you understand it better. So here we are on FamilySearch, and you have to sign in. Everyone has to sign in to access the really cool features on FamilySearch. I'll see you after I put in my personal information. After you log in, you're on the homepage. So let me walk you through a few features. The first is the announcement box. So on FamilySearch, there's lots of different things that they want you to know about, conferences and events, as well as some specific collections and challenges they have. So that's what that box is all about. Now this box right here is pretty cool because it tells you some recommended activities that you can do, again, after you link yourself to your deceased ancestors and see the trees that is already built by other collaborators on the platform. So some of the texts you're going to see are record hints. So I can click on this link right here and I can see how am I connected to this E. Bruner Peak. Well, it's up my line through the Andrew Jackson Peak that Caleb has been working on this YouTube channel to let you know about the discoveries he made. So that's how I'm related, and then I can click on this hint, and it's Kentucky marriage records, and then I can jump right in and start doing some research right there. So FamilySearch is like a virtual assistant for you, always working, always searching the databases to see if they can find some hints for you. Some other things you're going to see as you scroll down, you're going to see that some other people had put some things on the platform. So here is a photo of Arvilla Faith Comfort, and it was added by Kay Strayed. Thank you so much, Kay Strayed, if you're watching, and she added it 3 months ago. Here is a death record that Jean Christensen, she added for one of my relatives. I want to introduce you to a few other cool features that you're gonna see. The first one is recent people. Now, do you ever have the time when you work on a website for genealogy and you're not exactly sure who you worked on last because it's been maybe a few days or maybe some months or longer? Well, this is a list of where you left off. So the last time I logged in, I was working with Robert Paul and then Mr. Claybaugh and Magdalena Margareta Hoppe. Love it. So the other thing I haven't started right yet is this to-do list. So the to-do list can be a reminder of some things that you want to work on. So let's add a to-do list. Let's say I wanted to research the Ohio tax record collection for Chester Ward in Huron, Ohio, and I can go ahead and add that, and then I've reminded myself what I want to do next, and when I'm done, I can X out of it just like that. Next, let's take a tour of some really cool features that you are going to want to explore. So the Family Tree tab takes you to a few things. First, it can take you to your tree. Let me get my little handy dandy marker and you're gonna see some things. Well, first, this is the focal person. It could be you. So this focal person is here in the center, and then you go up the different lines for the different maternal, paternal, things of that nature. So in this view, however, it is any stories attached to these folks. And as you can see, I've got relatives right here that have stories. You're gonna have to watch another video that I have about the different types of charts on FamilySearch, but that's how you get to the charts. You get them by going to the family tree. So next you can look at a person, and this will take you to the person tab. And here is a person page. You're gonna see the name of the individual right there. If there's a picture attached to them, you'll see it right here. And remember, you don't need to clutter up FamilySearch with a bunch of junk pictures that you see on Ancestry. Just keep it to faces, maybe some tombstones or records, but we don't need graphics like ships and flags and flowers. Scrolling down, this is the life sketch section. So you can add a life sketch. So George was a pattern maker for the B&O Railroad in Columbus, Ohio. So you can use this life sketch section in order to tell people a little bit about the person that you're exploring, in this case, this Robert Paul Geisler Sr., to help others keep people separate. Then you're gonna see the vitals information, name, birth date and place, death date and burial. Now, Penelope wanted to know, how do I get from a login to timeline? Let me go ahead and address that now. You logged in, you went to family tree up here, you went to person, and then you come over to this link right here that says timeline, and there you have it. And so you can see all the little markers from the different activities they did. And you see that Cincinnati? That's when he and his wife eloped. It's a pretty interesting family story. So you scroll down, you've got the vital information, you have additional information. I really love using this to keep track of my ancestors when I find them in city directories, census records, pension files, and like. It's kind of like a timeline of sorts here as well. And these features, when you have a little pin next to it, will come over here and show up on the timeline. It's very cool. Then you have the family, husband, wife, children, and then his parents and his siblings. I hope that's pretty self-explanatory. Then you can have, we have a video about what the find tab was about like. Go ahead and check that out on our channel. And lists are great because how many of you don't like people changing your tree? I totally understand. So what you can do is you can watch people and you can see when somebody makes changes. Now, in this case, it's blank because this is my teaching account, but trust me, in my other account, lots of people are changing my tree and I can go and interact with them. Some of those changes are extremely beneficial, like that picture that we saw at the beginning of the video. And some of them is an opportunity for me to talk to other researchers and try to figure out a good solution. We have lots of videos about the collaborative nature of the FamilySearch platform. Check in the FamilySearch tips playlist that I will include in the description section for more of those types of videos. Quickly, we're gonna go through a few more things to keep this video short. The next part of a newbie's guide to FamilySearch is to check out the search tab. So the tree is where you're going to organize and keep track of all of your information. Your search tab is where you're going to access records. So if I wanted to find records for George Geisler, we have lots of tips on how to search. Let's keep it simple. We'll do a search and see what comes up. We're gonna see various record hints and then I can go and explore. There's the family tree search. This is when I want to search for people that are in the tree. It's another way to access the tree. So search family tree is the same as the find. Genealogies, now these are submitted genealogies from a variety of different places, like the Guild of One Name Studies, which we've talked about on this YouTube channel with Paul House. Gotta check out that video. There's other things you can search, the catalog. There's a lot of records on FamilySearch that are not available from the search form. They are in the browse section. There's also a catalog to the Family History Library, and you're gonna find it here. You can also search for books and the wiki. Now we'll have videos in the future, or we already have them, about both of these services, so be sure to check out our research videos. Finally, you have the memories section. Really believe that we should be capturing and preserving family memories. Here's a gallery of the pictures that I have uploaded. And on this teaching account, I haven't uploaded very many, but other people have. Check out all these really, really cool items. I can search for people. And so this is going to show me, I can filter by close relatives added by me, not attached to my family. And you can go in and click and see the different media and the memories that people have attached. Very cool. Hope you check that out. And then finally, indexing. And we have a video about indexing as well, so be sure to check the description. So it's a really massive website, isn't it, you guys? I hope you can navigate around FamilySearch. So as I've mentioned, we have a playlist of research tips for FamilySearch that will pop up on screen and will also be in the description section. So I hope this is a good introduction to FamilySearch for you. And be sure to check out that FamilySearch playlist. Yeah, I'm gonna give you lots of ways to get more tips on FamilySearch or other videos about how to be a better researcher.